I'm Ron Patterson with Utah State University Extension. Weeds do not recognize property boundaries, and so they really are everybody's problem. Today's Weed Warrior topic is Dyers Woad. Here's a young Dyers Woad. You can identify them quite easily with that light colored midrib. It goes right down the middle of the leaf. But this one is going to probably sit here all summer long as a rosette and send down a good tap root, and then next year it'll bolt into a flower if it doesn't get pulled up. Notice that the rosettes have a simple leaf, and it's almost entire, and they have a long petiole that goes from the rosette up to the leaf blade. On the other hand, the leaf on the flower stalk is a clasping leaf where it's attached right down, right around that stem. The flowering stalk is kind of a brownish reddish color, and the leaves are also a little bit kind of a bluish tint or grayish tint to those leaves. As a biennial, Dyers Woad will germinate in the spring or summer and grow and form a rosette. This rosette will grow throughout the summer and send down a taproot. It's a massive taproot. It'll go down as far as 5 feet, and it will give that Dyers Woad a competitive advantage over some of the other plants around in the springtime. So the rosette then will set through the winter and get a chilling process. It's called vernalization. So that vernalization will chill that and tell it to send up the flower stalks. The next spring, the second spring, it will send up this flower stalk and produce seeds in that second growing season. Sometimes when Dyers Woad germinates late enough in the summer or early fall, it'll put on a large enough rosette, grow a large enough rosette to go through the winter vernalization and then send up a seed stalk. So in that case, it actually behaves more like a winter annual, where it puts up a seed stalk in just that one season. It doesn't grow through a full summer growing season. Another situation that can happen is if you mow off the Dyers Woad, that doesn't kill the root. It will send up buds from the root down here, and so just mowing Dyers Woad doesn't really do the job. It'll send up buds, and it kind of behaves in that way more like a perennial. You can go through 2 or 3 years of Dyers Woad of that same plant until it sends up a seed stalk and produces seed. The thing is, Dyers Woad is a monocarpic biennial. In other words, it dies once it produces that one season of seed. It will die, that root will die, but then it's produced 500 seeds. So we have to come up with the control options for these different stages of growth. So Dyers Woad reproduces by seed. The main control efforts have to focus around keeping it from going to seed or keeping the seed from getting planted. So that's what we'll talk about, is how to keep this from producing seed and spreading to places we don't want it to be. Now, weed prevention is the best control option we have. So some of the things we can do to prevent it from getting onto our place is feed weed-free hay, or clean our equipment, our farm equipment, construction equipment, ATV equipment, anything that we've been operating where it's been infested with Dyers Woad. Be sure to clean that before you move it to some other place that hasn't been infested. Water is probably the most common way for Dyers Woad to be spread, whether it's along rivers or streams, along irrigation ditches, or even erosion coming down from the mountains. We want to make sure that we keep the Dyers Woad away from situations where it can spread with the water. Now, when you're trying to control the seedling or rosette or even early bud stage, you can use a herbicide application to control those, a broadleaf weed control such as 2,4-D or Tellar or Escort. I'll put links in the description of the video that will take you to a more detailed description of those herbicides and how you would apply those. But that's how you do the herbicide application. Now, when Dyers Woad is at the blossoming or bud stage or seed stage, you'll want to take out the root, chop those crown off on that Dyers Woad so that you've got it, you're going to kill the plant that way. You want to have at least a couple of inches of the root below the crown to make sure that you've got that killed out. If you don't, if you cut off above the crown or right at the crown, it will send up buds from that crown and you'll get more Dyers Woad growing. If the seeds, if it's just in blossom stage like this, you can let it lay. You don't have to throw it, put it in a bag. But if it's producing any seed at all, you need to put that into a bag and throw it away. Don't leave it on the ground or it will drop those seeds and produce more Dyers Woad. There is a biological control It's a fungus, a rust, that will get into the system, and it will affect some plants, but not every plant. So you can't really rely upon this rust to do the control that you need on the seed production. So it's there, but don't rely on it. Dyers woad is a serious problem in Utah, but ignoring it will not make it go away. Weeds really are everybody's problem, and it will take several years of control efforts to get a handle on this problem. So be a good neighbor, be a weed warrior.